Curious, can you only tell if it's a sit piece if you equip them? No, that says something about it somewhere. Oh, I never put this rig on anybody, by the way. Intelligence 7. This one. Intelligence 10. Sheila's got... There we go, that's a better one. For example, Kayla's got... What has she got that's a set item? This one here. Shepherd's Axe. It says it on top. It says it right... you know what I mean. I can't control my arm the right way. This way. Right there. So even if it's not equipped, you can see. Here we go. Hi!
Calling my spells tricks is such a disservice.
Tito, you made a bad money boo-boo last night. Our friend suggested a restaurant for our potential rehearsal dinner spot. We sat down and, welp, once we opened the menu, we knew we were screwed. And you can't just leave, you know. Why? Of course you can just leave. Of course you can. Wait, Azara, didn't we leave? What did we leave? We left the restaurant at some point. I forgot what happened. I remember doing that, though. As long as you didn't order anything yet, you can leave. Well, I hope it was good, Tito. Was it good, at least? There's something about these monsters that are not optimized. It takes a little... The combat takes a little longer. They're gonna kill Sheila. Look at this. They attack Sheila like every time. Ew! Ew! Alright. Kill him. We walked into a place once, waited at the entrance for like 5 minutes, and we just turned around and left. I remember sitting down. Was it? I don't know. It was all a dream. I dreamed it. Next character, please. Don't kill Sheila. Oh, okay. Yes. See? I knew we'd walk out of a place. It was one of those places that where you would be that one young couple that did that. Where you wouldn't want to be one of the... So here's the thing. Are you ever going to go again? And if the answer to that is no, then who cares? I understand why you stayed, but and I don't want to make you feel bad for the decision. And I sincerely hope it was really good food. Let's do that. These fights are actually pretty tough. These robots. I do a lot of damage. I feel like I'm constantly healing Cheetla.
May your souls never see the light of the upper world.
So, Tito, you said the steak was the best thing ever, like hands down the best. Well, there you go. That you should lead that story in with, hey, we went to a restaurant. I had the best steak of my life. Instead of, I went to a restaurant and it was way more expensive than I wanted it to be. That's the story. The story is you had the best steak of your life. Well, there you go. Chain cowl. Hey, she gained a level. Nice. I think it's very important for folks to remember. You have to do what's best for you sometimes, you know? And sure, it could get a little socially awkward or whatever, but if you're not going to see that person ever again, and you're not hurting anybody, and you're not doing anything illegal, then why not? Okay. That is not the best helmet. All right, everybody's leveled up. Let's do a quick level up session here. Boop. All right, what do we want to do? Energy cost, intelligence, fire damage bonus. Yes. Here we go. We'll make him a pyro. 2 intelligence, 1 vigor. Confirm. Kayla. We can go down and get perfect strike now with the insta-kill ability. Let's try it. Let's equip it. I never use this, so let's use that. Yeah, keep the stun. Give her 1 strength. One intelligence, 1 vigor. Confirm. Meze. Brute force. I'm rarely turtling, so let's get brute force. That removes stun. That removes taunt, which is great. Strength, vigor. He's got a new passive. The party gets 15% hit chance bonus for 3 turns if you taunt an enemy. It has a 50% chance to remove the fear effect from all party members. We're rarely using taunt here. But we can try. Oh, she's got one too. Unity, increase 20% damage resistance when you have an active minion. Oh, we're gonna get that. We're getting that. Bogotter's got one too. Alteration, 10% of your energy costs are paid with hit points in exchange for 15% damage. Hell yeah. That's gonna kill me, I know it. All right, and she's got, while below 25% life, your skill energy costs are reduced to 0. Oh my gosh. Your sun skills cost less. Are all of her things sun skills? They're not even sun skills. Let's do this. This is great. Hit points, who needs those? I know, right? Meze, we gave him stuff to. All right, and Sheila. Restore character from incapacitated state. Yeah, we gotta go to that now. Yes. So now she can res people. What? She can literally res people. No blindness. Just res. Lots of resing. And let's give her 2 intelligence and 1 vigor. Actually, we're gonna go, we gotta go more. You know what? I'm gonna go triple vigor. She's dying way too much. She needs to live. You missed her intro. What's her race? She's a goddess. We found her. The top of the world tree.
Those trained in the way of the Taltosh once rode horses with metal coats, copper included.
Please tell me the horses wore saddles.
Constant movement atop metallic fur would chafe.
Exactly.
She does have more hit points than Bog on her, but she gets attacked more.
I take it this is where
more.
We process the copper branches.
I don't know why.
As much as I respect Hador as a god, his machinery is rather down to earth.
It will do the job, but we may need to make some adjustments first.
All right, we don't even have all the pieces yet, right? We got a Gladius. Sheila, what is she using? What are you using? Yeah, she's got wands and stuff. You don't need that. You don't need that, Sheila. Oh. The bench is just for firewood. Okay, fine. Speaking of firewood, we haven't found a save game point since we got to this level. That's making me a little Monka S right now. I'm a little nervous, not gonna lie. I love that this is like a metal forest. How's it going, Knight of Mercury? Monka S, yep. Bethel. Oh god, there's 5 of them.
Lore and his knife.
Trangator says, I need someone to take away my bag of coconut peanut M&Ms, please. M&Ms are too good. Peanut M&Ms? Ugh. Coconut peanut M&Ms. I don't know if I've tried that. That's probably way good. Knight of Mercury says, I'm doing good. Been listening while working. This is so my game, but I need another one to add to my list. Like I need a hole in my head. I understand, man. It's so good, though. You know, I don't know most of the emote meanings at this point. I'm afraid to ask. You can always ask here, Tito. I wouldn't know them except for Azaria. Azaria knows all of them. Monka S means like a... Oh, that makes me nervous or gives me anxiety or it's a tense emotion. All right, should we heal? Monk sweat, is that what it is? Sweaty. Shveti. Yeah, the other on fire. Uh-oh. We're gonna do an AoE heal. Mass heal. missed with the potion. Really now?
Abracadabra.
Do I have a personal definition to the Choya? Puka puka. Puka puka. You look at it as an ah fudge, I'm in danger moment. I think it's more like you say something like dumb and someone calls you on it and you're like, Choya. That's what I think it's more like. It's like your defense for someone calling you dumb and them being accurate. They accurately call you dumb, so you're like, hey, 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 hey. Choya. That'd be like a derp. Yeah, kind of like a derp. Derp. This is cool as hell. Guys, this is really cool, but I need a place to save it. You know, I bet the save is like all the way back in the beginning over here. We're like running really low on everything. I can't even really. What did I just do? Oh, there's a chest here. Oh God, no! Don't fight me! Forgot to look for chests here. Should I go all the way back? All right, let's go back. Rudder inspired me. Thank you for inspiring me. Or it could be this way. Oh wow, there's so many ways to go. Oh no. No fights. No fighting. Thanks, Justice. Your encouragement is meaningful. There's another way here. Oh my God, there's so many ways I missed. I need, all I need is a resting place. Here we go. I found a resting place. Rest.
I will say, this copper forest is quite spectacular.
Spectacular.
I know that I like it here. This grandeur cannot be disputed.
Would you believe it is the least of the three forests in the upper world? As the third son of Aron Anyachka, the Golden Father, and Hoinal Anyachka, the Dawn Mother, Hadur received the third most grand of these forests.
I'm never going to remember those names.
Of course, his older brothers Nopkirai and Sailkirai preside over the Golden Forest and Silver Forest, respectively.
Nopkirai. That's the Sun King, right?
The eldest of the three brothers, yes. And Selkirai is the King of the Wind.
Any other long names of Upperworlders I've never heard before and will promptly forget once you tell me?
Most definitely. In fact, I'm not sure where to start.
Save it all for later. That's probably for the best.
All right, number...
You'll want to see what has just arrived.
My finger! First of all, I love that we're seeing Central European like mythology and folklore. This is great. Like this, these are like tales we never hear. Okay, that's one thing. Number two, the Hungarian language is amazing. I love these names. I can't say most of them, but I love them. Natafinga. True. Let's rest. What did she say?
You won't find better prices in all of Operencia.
Taltosh
Seriously?
Robes. 26,000?
Have you even seen another place to buy weapons?
26,000. I am at 19. Various leathers decorated with animal bones, flowers, skulls, feathers, and other natural adornments. 10% to fear Wisdom 4, Vigor 1. What's so great about those? They're not that great. For 26,000? That's highway robbery. It's robbery, I tell ya! Save a game. That guy sounds like Yoda. It's weird. Yeah, I don't like the way he sounds. He does sound like Yoda, but he sounds like a young guy trying to do an older guy's voice. You know? Something off about it. I agree. The Copper Forest. Bodejar. I was right, it was over here. Are you saying he's not a real Tatosh? No, he's not a real Tatosh. His voice actor is not a real Tatosh. I hate how fast these Golemancies are. They always go first and they always... What is it they have against Chila? Like, what is it? They target her every time. Summon Frank. There's Golemancy. See, you love this part, don't you? Golemancy lives in the Copper Forest, doesn't he? I think Golemancy is the god that reigns over here. He's Hadur. He's Hadur. That's a new move.
Sparkles. Sparkles.
Golemancy's like, totes, these are my peeps. Golemancy likes creatures with saw blade arms. Come on. Twenty-six damage.
Sometimes I wish I excelled at things other than taking life.
Let me see if there's chests. 33 meters.
With one more, we will have enough to refine what we have collected.
Hi! Only three?
I see no threat in you.
By the way, I forgot to tell you guys. Last night, as I'm putting my older son to bed, I grabbed him and I'm like, I'm gonna wrestle you on the bed, right? So I grab him and I have him and I took a big step toward the bed, and under his bed, he's got these pull out drawers, right? And one of the drawers was slightly ajar. So where I thought the end of the bed was not quite the end of the bed because the drawer was sticking out. And I smashed my foot into this drawer. And I immediately let go of my son and crumpled onto the bed, screaming. And now I have a big, my middle toe on my left foot is all purple. The whole toe. And I've been limping around. I even told Azaria last night, I think I broke my toe. How can I work? I gotta take the rest of the week. How can I work with a broken toe? And then she laughed at me. I'm like, oh yeah, I guess I can work with a broken toe. You're sorry you laughed at that. That's okay. It's funny. It's purpley, though. Karma for grappling your kid. I still fought him afterwards, after the pain subsided a bit. I like wrestling. Bing, ding. And you didn't post it on a Patreon lens? I thought about it, Marauder, showing you the toe, but nasty. Who wants to see that? Who wants to see nasty old guy foot?
No one is forever.
We get enough nasty feet while watching you play Sekiro. That's right, that guy. That one hairy leg guy. I want these crystals. This seems like a bigger map.
In here, we will melt the copper from the tree branches.
I know this machinery well. As the numbers increase, the hanging pod descends. There will be an ideal location indicated on the machine.
What? Say that again, but slower. If my feet are nasty, I should treat them better. I do maintenance on the feet, but it seems to like last very, very little days. But yeah, you're right. Kazvi, you got your Avenger tickets for Saturday the 27th. Nice. See, now I'm feeling all this pressure. All you guys getting these tickets. I'm sorry, should we be getting tickets or do we wait a week or two and then we don't have to? I don't know what to do. Snake staff. Energy 16%. Wow. Take that. That's a lot more energy. What does their energy go up to? 348 from 326. That's nice. Okay. You might want to check kid scheduling and do an early movie. We could do that. Yeah, remind me later. We should try to get tickets maybe. I don't mind waiting, like I don't need to like see it right away, but I am afraid of spoilers and stuff. You know? Okay, so what are we doing with this?
There is a reason the number 23 is specified here.
Okay. What the hell did that do? So that's 21. Oh, that goes up. Okay, so this is gonna be 13.
The depth is correct. But an empty pot does us no good.
Huh? Okay, what does that mean? We made Renami panic. Oh, I enjoy it when there's less people in the theater too, Pinky Fluff. One second, gang. I will say, though, there were two occasions where having an audience, like a full theater, was really amazing. See, every time I blow my nose, it causes me to sneeze. I saw Sixth Sense in a packed theater, and everybody was getting scared out of their minds at that movie. And that movie's not like overly scary, but when everyone in the theater is like screaming at certain scary things, it makes it scarier. And then when the twist happens later on in the movie, there was this wave of energy that went through the audience, like, oh, and like it put chills, like literal chills down my arms. And like, I was so enthralled by the movie. And I think everybody else's reaction just, it was a very visceral moment. So that added to it. And then there was one of the Star Wars movies when Yoda like takes out his lightsaber for the first time and actually battles. Like, everybody in the audience was, yes! And like, it was just such a rush, you know? So there's times where the audience can add to the experience, but most of the time, they just distract you by opening up their goober package or talking or something like that. Yeah. You're like 9 Marvel movies behind Dragon Tears. You have time. Catch up. They're so good. Justice just says, I need to watch the Ant-Man and Wasp movie, then I'm good for all the Marvels. Azari and I just caught up with that couple days ago. I think that was the last one we needed to, or at least I needed. Hey, Hawaii girl, what's going on? Okay, so what happened here with the bucket? Coming all the way back up. Oh, now it's gonna come up, okay. Yeah, I saw Captain Marvel. All right, what do we want to put in here? We're gonna have to smelt. Is it long enough? Is it heavy enough? Is it flexible enough? Is it thick enough? Oh my. Stinky boot. Copper crown. We don't have anything to put in there. Okay. So, we gotta come back here. Can I say those 4 things again? Is it heavy, long, flexible, and thick? I think you just baited me into saying that. Oh my.
For honor!
There's a big surprise. Pick on Sheila. I blame you, Alaska. I blame you. For making me say that again. How you doing, Elf on the Shelf? How was your weekend? Mass heal! The melee combat, like the basic attack, I think also needs to be buffed. Because it's like almost worthless for Meze or Kayla to attack without using a skill.
Your death was meaningless.
White Girl says, does anyone know if watching Captain Marvel is extremely important plot-wise before watching Endgame? Kind of. I would do it, Hawaii Girl. Honestly, I would go see Captain Marvel first before Endgame. I think she's going to be a very important character in the next in Endgame. Yeah. Oh, definitely want to watch Infinity War first. You have to watch Infinity War first, but yeah. You wouldn't say it's the best Marvel movie out there? Elf on a Shelf. I think Captain Marvel is amazing. I think it's a great movie. May not be the best, but it's great. All right, what's this? Chest key, okay. A breastplate. For Meze. You lose the vigor and the lightning resistance. We get a lot more defense. Yeah, let's wear it. Why not? You haven't watched any of them since Age of Ultron, Marauder? I really love them. I can't even talk. I mean, I'm a huge fan of Marvel and superhero stuff, right? But more than that, I don't think there's ever been, or may never will be again, another series of movies and TV shows that are all have continuity with each other and crossovers and references than this. It is so well, like, thought out, like years and years and years of movies and TV shows intertwined. It's just so much fun as a fan to watch it all connect together. Yeah, it's so good. Helvetica Ball says, you can always read the comic book. It's true. True. Did I hear that James Gunn is back on GOTG3? I don't know who James Gunn is or what GOTG3 is. So no, I didn't hear that. Who's that? I love that Frank comes in and heals people. It's great. Oh, Guardians of the Galaxy. Oh. James Gunn is the director for that? Okay, gotcha. You derp too? See? Hey, Tan Liel. How's it going? Hey, Tony Bob. He got fired a while back. I haven't followed that news, so I don't know. I love Guardians of the Galaxy 1 and 2. They're both great. All right. These guys are jerks. All right, I really don't like fighting these guys. Come on. There you go, Frank. Moves all dots. These guys take too long to fight because there's something that's not optimized about the combat. There's some effect that takes a little while. Yeah, Chila's dead. Almost our wizard's almost dead. Oh, come on. And there he goes. Two dead. There we go. Holy cow. Furred boots. Ideal for long walks through cold environments. Okay. Let's do some hailing. Helvetica says, what I liked about reading comments way back in the 70s and 80s was the immense shared universe story you're seeing today in the movies. It's true. Hathanka followed 8 minutes ago. Thank you so much. Welcome to the stream. Let us know if you have any questions about what's going on or what we do here. You're not a movie watcher? Marauder, I can cure you. Marauder, get yourself your cell phone or your tablet, load up some Summoner's War, pick your favorite dungeon, and movie binge. You can't do it? Oh, see, I like watching TV and movies. Real quick, gang, allow me to talk about our new sponsor to anybody who wasn't here at the start of the stream today. We have been contacted by a company called Neo, and they have sponsored us for the next 3 months. This is the world's first crossbar, which they describe as candy bar taste inside of a protein bar. They only have 90 calories, 1 gram of sugar, and 8 grams of protein, and, they are sponsoring us. If you want 10% off on trying this, unfortunately, it's US only right now. You can type exclamation point Neo. That brings you to the Amazon link where you can take a look at these bars. They're really good. I've had them before I even signed up for sponsorship with them. I made them send me a box so I could try them. Azari and I devoured the box like immediately. And it's a great snack without a lot of sugar. It's only 1 gram of sugar in each. If we support them through the community enough, that 3 month trial sponsorship could be extended. So it'd be great that even if you don't have interest personally, if you know anybody that is on a health kick or wants to have, you know, a snack or that little sweet tooth but doesn't want tons of sugar, please go and try to support it. You can type the word Bog Otter at checkout. It's very important that you do that to get your 10% off and also to give us credit for the sale. So thank you guys. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. So for, and we're going to do it. We did a giveaway earlier today, but we're going to do a giveaway once a week. Give away a box of those as well. All right. Commercial over. I think this is one of the bigger maps that we've seen. We're only 45% done on this map. Here we go, here's another one.
That's it.
Well, that's
enough copper to create the key we need.
Okay, so now I gotta process the copper. This one says, is it dense enough? So the 10% off is also for 3 months? Yes. You can use that as many times as you want over the course of the 3 months. It does not expire. So just use Bog Otter, and that's how they track that it came from us. And they said that they're going to, basically, the analytics they're looking for is just sales. So if we sell enough, they'll, at the end of the 3 months, we can renegotiate a contract and extend it. And I also want to hear your guys' feedback on it, you know? Let me know when you get them, if you try them, what you think. And then if you really love them, help us promote it. Bye, Elf on a Shelf. Take care. Lightning bugs. I get 1,000 hugs. Lightning immune. Well, that kind of sucks. It sucks to be her, huh? Just lightning and lightning. Okay. We'll taunt them.
That's the sound it makes when you hit 20 months of subbing. Thanks.
Hey, Amy. Hi. Thank you so much for the 20-month resub with Twitch Prime. How you doing? Let's get some hype and love in the chat for Hey, Amy. Hey. Free shipping options, too, because it's through Amazon. You're right, Tony Bob. Yep. Those boxes on Amazon, those are 12 bars in each box. So with the 10% discount, it comes out to like 22 or something like that. And I think there's even like a $2 coupon on Amazon too that you can click. So you can get it for like 20 bucks free shipping for the 12 bars. All right. Man. They're immune to everything she does. Perfect strike. Insta-kill!
Was it really worth it?
Is that our first time getting an insta-kill? I think that is. The entire playthrough. We have certain moves that do insta-kills. With a percent chance.
Taking life does not heal my soul.
Naka, thank you so much for grabbing a box. You're super sweet. Thank you very much. What the hell just happened? I don't know. Oh, there we go. Rainami says the new Namco bundle is sweet. Can you give me a synopsis of what's in it, Rainami? He's talking about our humble partner Link. What's in it? Isn't it crazy how often Humble comes out with like new stuff? They're like always, there's always like a new sale, a new bundle, a new monthly. The Humble Monthly's still active, right? You guys have a little bit of time left if you want to snag Mutant Year Zero and a couple other games before the Humble Monthly turns over. Renabi says, Tekken 7, Swear Your Oath in God Eater 2, Rage Burst, and Escape the Maw in Little Nightmares. So it's Tekken, God Eater, Little Nightmares. Oh, nice.
You'll want to see what has just arrived.
My finger!
You won't find better prices in all of Operencia.
Troll's Cleaver.
Seriously.
All right.
Have you even seen another place to buy weapons?
Do we need a Troll Cleaver? Probably. It's a powerful weapon to you, but for Troll, it's dinnerware. It's crit damage, 14%, strength 10, armor piercing 40. Yeah, let's get this. Meze deserves everything. Meze's such a nice guy. Rest up. Save game. Meze! Troll Cleaver! Yeah, Troll Cleaver. Very good. Are they sold individually in stores? I would love to try one to see if I like it, because I'm still looking for a bar that I like taste of. Hawaii Girl, I believe they're a small company. I think they just started things up recently. I think they only distribute at Amazon.com right now, and you have to buy a box. I'm not sure if they're sold individually in stores though. Ooh, I get attacked from behind. I will say that they're chocolatey. They're not chalky like a lot of other protein bars. And they're also not super chewy. Like sometimes protein bars, you're like chewing forever. Like what were the bars? I used to have like this like cookie dough protein bar that I used to like, but let's just buy, like, I'd be halfway through the bar and I'd be like, oh man, I'm sick of chewing, I'm already full. I like these a lot. Alright, let's summon Frank. Lightning immune. Well, she really has nothing to do against these things.
Should have stayed home.
Indeed. My god, dog out of nowhere.
I have cheese for him. I have some. Oh. I'm gonna feed him. He just woke up.
Okay. Fine, steel gloves. This is like the Meze dungeon. Yeah. Yeah, these are much better. Yay. All right. All right, it all connects. Surprise! Ambush! White Girl says, sold with the non-chewy and non-chalky. That's the consistency with most bars to try and trash. So if these bars aren't like those, I may have to pick a box. If you decide to do it, just use the link that Alaska put in the chat. And make sure you type Bog Otter at checkout on Amazon. I know it's weird. Like, Bog Otter would actually work on Amazon. It actually works for the coupon code or gift card section. Then you get 10% off and it counts as a sale for us. And remember, if I'm offline and you decide you want some more or to buy them, you can always go to my profile. There's a little graphic down on my profile. Click it, and then you can get there. It also links to my Amazon referral link, which helps the stream as well. So it's like double help. Why does Amazon auto-click things you don't want to buy? You may like these too, so just gonna add them to your cart. I never had that happen to me a single time. Really? I've never seen that. Sheila's dead? Yep, Sheila's dead. Every time. These guys, I don't know what it is about their AI. They attack her constantly.
No one lives forever.
She's a healer, I guess so. I guess so. Get out of here.
They challenged. We prevailed.
Barely. Got some levels gaining. Okay, we got this way. That's a dead end. Unless we still haven't found a way to cross water, which is a obstacle that we've found many, many times so far in this game. Right here is another dead end. I don't know if we can cross that water or not. All right. 66% of the map. Are they only in the prime pantry? Not prime pantry, no. Steel boots. Meze. Meze's like, yes, new boots, please. Leather sandals. Why are leather sandals so good? It's very strange. You do need an Amazon account, yes. Maverick says, no one lives forever. What? Who are you? What did you do with my pool of life? Hashtag ring. How's it going, man? All right. Immune to lightning and stun. Another level? Oh god. Oh god. There's a treasure over here. Alright. Let's go down here. Oh! Something new! We got new stuff, guys. Of course, I'm an idiot and I go the other way. Let's go toward the new stuff. Oh, is that a trap? Oh, it shoots! Look! Oh, all right. That's awesome. Let's be careful here. What is that thing? All right, just mapping out the room. All right, how do we open this? Let us in. Okay, can't get in there. You snagged a box too, Alaska? Thank you so much. Thank you for supporting our sponsors, gang. You guys always come through for me with these things. Thank you.
Four locked doors in a row. Someone really didn't want outsiders like us in here.
The note we found referenced the four elements.
Fire,
earth, water, and air. Maybe there's a connection. Locked. And we don't have the right key.
True. We don't.
I wish you no harm.
Jenny Hayden. Oh my gosh. I wish you no harm. I mean you no harm, Jenny Hayden. Come on, who got that reference? That's a tough one. That's a tough one. And Dragon Tears is about to say, what reference? I didn't hear it. But her ears always perk up when I say movie wreckness. See? I knew it! I knew it! Dragon Tears, I know you like a book. Her ears perk up when she hears movie quote, because she wants to test. She never hears it the first time, though. Okay, so the movie quote is, oh no, now I remembered it. Oh, she knew it already. It was, I mean you no harm, Jenny Hayden. Oh my god, Marauder, you were on top of that. You were on top of that. I mean you no harm, Jenny Hayden, yes. Damn. Starman is a great movie. If you haven't seen Starman, carve out some time to see it. I like that movie a lot. It's a very interesting movie. And Jeff Bridges does an amazing job in that movie. He plays an alien who takes the form of a human. And, like, of course he's alien, so he doesn't know how to act human. And Jeff Bridges does an amazing job, like, portraying somebody in human skin that just does not comfortable in human skin. Yeah. It's pretty cool to see. I don't know why I did the stun move against that, but I did. I did it anyway. Regen a little bit. Also watch Krull. Well, I always recommend Krull. Krull's just too good. Yes, the stoplight part, Pecunius. Dutch apple pie. It's terrific. My brother and I used to quote that all the time. It's terrific. All right, got it. Go, Frank, go. Jessica, you're right. You are right, though. Best person to act like an alien who's not comfortable in human skin is Edgar from Men in Black, Vincent D'Onofrio. That is great. I haven't thought of that in so long. I used to do an impression of that verse, that line he does, but I don't remember the line. I have to, like, brush up on it and then do it. I used to do an impression. Something like a pet cat. He's talking about the pet cat. How the pet cat meant the world to me. That's great, but I will say that Jeff Bridges in Starman is much more subtle. Much more subtle than that. Yeah, Ranger Bow. I don't even have to look at the Ranger Bow. Alright, Will. I have no idea what to do in here. Let's go smelt the key. Stole that chest over there. Look at that. I don't know how to get in there. Feeling called out. I'm not calling you out. I just know you. You love all three Men in Black movies? Yeah, I know three was bad, but I love them all. Sparkwood. I don't think I've seen three. After over 3 years of spending most days together, it was bound to happen. True. Well, I just know, like, you're working, you know, you've got your family there, you mod and watch other streams, so you're, like, you're distracted. But you always have that ear out. And when you hear movie quote time, you're like, what? I'm here.